Thank God, Brother Rick. We've been praying for you this week, and we just felt like sending you the tape. Thank God. Oh, we missed you so much, Brother Rick. Thank God, we just service hadn't been the same without you. Here's the dose. He's gonna give you a message tonight, Brother Rick.
Yeah.
was a little bit of Zodi for you. I tell you, she's been practicing lately. She's down here in the country now. She's been off all summer, having a good time, having plenty of time to get on the piano. And I think it's pretty good. I really like her music a lot. We just got back from Kansas City this weekend. Vaughn and Kenny came down. They were from came down from St. Louis and had a really nice time. Boy, that Kenny, he is crazy. You ought to see what he's been doing lately, Rick. I ain't kidding. It is funny. He has these black frame glasses with a built-on great big huge nose, and he puts them on, man, and he looks so funny. And oh man,
not only that, he has some Martian eyes. they bulge out and they're white and they have red veins all through them, and he just looks like a complete zombie.
Man, he looks like the latest space case from the ozone or something. And we go, whenever we're going somewhere in the car, he'll put them on when he's driving and stuff, and people just stare at him really funny.
This is what he did today, Dad. We were driving in downtown Armadale, all them armor gators looking at him. Okay, so there's this little girl, you know, and Kenny's saying, "Hi there, how are you? You know, you're on Kenny's camera." So this little girl's about 6 years old, man, and she says, "Oh, no, really? Oh, you're kidding, not me. I can't handle this."
She believed him.
And we were laughing so hard, man. We got into driving around Armadale, and Kenny the ultimate. Thank God, but indeed it love you. He coming back. Thank God, you better be prepared. And it was funny because he had on those nose and glasses and those eyes. And it was hilarious. And we had a great time in Kansas City.
I've just been mainly just, I've been blowing quite a bit of glass. And I've wholesaled a whole lot this summer to different gift shops and stuff. And that's about all I've did, you know.
And
really, we've been going swimming every day, man. It's just getting too hot, you know, to blow glass.
I don't think we can handle Dallas 16 days without swimming.
Really?
Especially with as hot as it was last year.
You're going to have to get a swimming hole for us, Rick, really, man. Boy, we just got your letter just this evening. We just got home from Kansas City, and it's like it's 11:30 right now, Monday night. We just got home, and your letter got here today, I guess. And man, it was really great hearing from you, Rick, man. Oh. I'm gonna play you a tune on the guitar pretty soon. I have to change strings, but I'm gonna let Zoe play another one on the piano for you. Here you go, Rick, another solo by none other than Zoe Ganda. Here's a new fiddle tune I learned. I really like playing. It's called Lonesome Reuben, Rick. It's a good tune.
Mm-hmm. Thank you. hopefully in the booth. Bill's going to call him and ask him about that. But that would be so fantastic if Vaughn comes down to talk about party. Oh, okay. It's going to be great. Remember last year, Dallas, we had a lot of fun.
Really, I'm seriously thinking about taking my old truck down there, Rick. I really don't have room for it, but I ought to just tow it down there just to see if all of us could fit in it again. Boy. Let me think. It's getting awful late, Rick. We sure have been missing you, though, Rick, man. Whenever me and Zoe were driving home today, I was just thinking, man, it'd be so neat if, like, Kenny and Vaughn could move down here, and if you could move down here, and all of us blow glass and just sell it wholesale or go to state fairs or something. But boy, it'd be neat if we could all live down here. We'd have a good time on this lake and everything out in the country. Really?
Can't wait to come down. That's all I've got to say.
Thank God. Let's hear a testimony from Tita Doll. Tita Doll, can you give us a testimony tonight? Thank God. Either.
Brother Burns! Brother Burns! I'm telling you. I can't hardly stand to sit still. Jesus come in and touch me, oh Lord. I'm telling you. I'm telling you, Brother Rick, you better come up and see us even before Dallas, or we just won't be able to make it. Oh, my Lord, my Lord, my dot, straight dot. Hey, look, we're going to come and see you.
Ricky, man, kidding. He does, you know the Three Stooges? Well, you know Mo? Isn't it Mozo?
Yeah,
okay,
no,
Mo.
Curly.
Curly is always talking, man. He goes like this. He did Curly getting the Holy Ghost, man. All right, Zoe's going to do it for you. Here's Curly getting the Holy Ghost, man.
Hey, Mo, guess what? No. I went to church. And you know what? This lady came up to me and pulled me down to the altar, and she said, say, Jesus. And I said, get away from me, you old ugly witch. No. Then all of a sudden, something came over me. And all of a sudden, I started talking in tongues, and it sounded like this. No. Hey, Mo, I feel great. No.
That's kind of only, he's really good at doing that. He just buzzes right on through it.
Me and Zoe's been going to St. Louis sometimes, and oh, man, we just have such a great time up there with Kenny and Vaughn. They're excellent hosts, man. Man, by the way, Kenny is taking guitar lessons now. He really wants to learn. And he's funny, man, because he wants to learn so bad, you know, but he doesn't know anything about music yet, you know. He can sing and stuff like that. But, man, his fingers are, like, hurting whenever he plays a G chord. And so far, he's learned 4 chords, you know. But he's doing really good. He's had, like, 3 lessons so far. And last time we went to St. Louis, I met his teacher. And man, his teacher can pick. He's really good. He's into bluegrass, and he plays a lot of the songs that I play, but he plays a lot more. He's really good. And man, he's just really a mellow dude too. I'm glad that Kenny's got a good teacher, because that guy put him on the right track. But man, I loaned Kenny my old guitar, that old Alvarez I had, and I'm picking my Gallagher. He's really excited. He'll get so excited, he'll start strumming, you know, and he starts sweating and stuff. He's just... But, man, I'm really glad he's learning. Well, Rick, I'll tell you, it's getting about close to 12:30, and I'm going to have to sign off and say goodnight, and I'll let Zoe take it from here, but I'm going to crash out, Rick, so... Watch out for Dallas this year is all I got to say. Watch out. Good night, Rick.
Well, the time is now 12:25. Thank you for all the good boys and girls.
Strumming my pain with his fingers, he was singing my life with his words. Killing me softly with his song, killing me softly with his song. Telling my whole life with his words, killing me softly with his song.
Whatever I want to say, huh? Well, first thing is to say this. Much further out than inevitable, Halloween is thy game. Sky King has come and wellness done, uncertain as it is uneven. Give us today hors d'oeuvres in bed, as we forgive those who have dressed up against us. Lead us not into inflation, but our liver, onions, and potatoes. For wine is a morgue and a shingle and a story for your father. Well, all right. A little bit of John Hartford there. I hadn't done that one in a while. Boy, I'll tell you something. I wish he'd be at Winfield this fall. That'd be really great. Because I fell in love with him at Winfield in the spring, boy. I wish he could have made it to that one up there. Boy, we had such a great time. But there'll always be next year, hopefully. Oh my goodness, my cigarette fell off the table. You know, Bill's going to make me a really neat birthday present. It's going to be a piece of a real big tree, you know. And we'll drill a hole in my piano right here on top of the keyboard, where the music stand is, and drill a hole down in there, and then it'll just come out and go out about 12 inches on each side and have like butterflies and mushrooms and frogs and things like that on it. And that'll be really neat. A clear piece of glass on a black piano is excellent. Our cats are tearing each other up. A few months back, I called Vaughn and Kenny, and we talked for a half an hour. And so, I was pretty crazy after talking to Kenny Vaughn, if you know what I mean. So, that night after I hung up, it was about 12:30, I guess. I wasn't really feeling all that good. I had a cold. But I really felt great after talking to Vaughn and Kenny, so I sat down at the piano, and I come up with this number. I hope you can handle it.
tea for the throat, a coffee for the brain. Your hot loving, hot damn. The sniffles they got me down, and the coffee got me hoarse. So I hop on over here and give me your main course. Now I should hope that Glenn ain't standing outside, because if he is, he's sure to be surprised to hear me singing the blues. Trying to tell you the news, because I need your love and to mend me through and through. So then I won't be so damn blue. Yeah, oh no.
So how was that?
When the sun goes to bed, that's the time you raise your head. Let your lot in life elaine ya. I can't blame ya, no, 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 elaine ya. Artita, so la di da. Can your part ever get much sadder? Ooh, that your lot in life, Lelania. No, I can't blame ya. No, 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 Lelania. Run your hand through your hair, paint your face with despair. That's your lot in life, Lelania. No, I can't blame ya. No, 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 Lelania. Oh, Lelania. When the sun goes to bed, that's the time you raise your head. That's your lot in life, Lelania. No, I can't blame ya. No, 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 Lelania. Oh, Lelania. Well, I wish I had a big fine horse and corn to feed him on, and Shady Grove to stay at home and feed him while I'm gone. Shady Grove, my little love, Shady Grove, I say, Shady Grove, my little love, I'm bound to go away. Well, I went to see my Shady Grove. She's standing in the door, her shoes and stockings in her hand, and her little bare feet on the floor. Shady Grove, my little love, Shady Grove, I say, Shady Grove, my little love, I'm bound to go away. Kiss from pretty little Shady Grove, sweeter than brandy wine, and there ain't no girl in this whole world that's prettier than mine. Shady Grove, my little love, Shady Grove, I say, Shady Grove, my little love, I'm bound to go away.
I were just sitting here thinking about what we should finish off this tape with, or try to finish off anyhow, and nothing kept coming to our mind. So all of a sudden this little flash of lightning went through my line, and I remembered you whenever, oh, I guess you were about 12, 10 to 12, with your little chemistry sets and things. Going into the hospital and keeping all your pills and then blowing them up. I think your toes, they used to pop up and hit the ceiling. Oh, gosh.
The good old days, Ruth. remember the good old days, Ruth.
Those were the days.
Back in Fort Worth, we used to sit on the back seat there and buy pieces of Super Bowl.
And I remember the time that Bill tore one of those things that hold your songbooks up, tore one of those off, and it had a nail sticking in it. I was sitting about two rows in front of you guys, and he'd lean over the seats and hit me on top of the head with it. And then my dad was preaching and got on to me and told me to go sit on the front row, man. I was so pissed off, man. I had nail marks and blood and everything, and I was getting in trouble. It was a bummer. With Cokes and radios and everything else, very conveniently with straws all the way from your boot up to your mouth and your radio in your hip pocket, and you'd have connections all the way up to your ear.
A thousand and one games of
being so bored in church was unreal. Bill called today to Dallas, and that guy sounded very favorable about having Vaughn's macrame in there. So, see, the thing is, she may not come if she can't have part of her macrame in there, you know, because it probably wouldn't be worth her while, you know. So she's trying to get it where we can have macrame in the booth and sell it, and then she'd help Bill, too. So he sounded really favorable, but he said he had to have a written request for that, so... Hopefully.
Yeah, I think Vaughn sells a lot of their macrame hangings there. But you know that little back corner space?
Back where the bar is.
And stuff. We'll probably hang up some macrames there.
Mm-hmm. here's another song. It's not quite as crazy as the last one. This is the first one I wrote and put music to.
Where the cold, clear mountain stream did roll, the green beech tree hung across the road. Iron-rimmed wagons caught the sun back in the year of 61. Now Sherman's army marched around in 64, burned Georgia down, sending wings to the feet of every living soul to me. Gray-coat soldiers have gone, marching in a ragged war. Young wives and babies cried alone. Oh, fathers, a summer more. Well, they tore up the rails and wrecked the bridge by that hill called Mission Ridge. Hell, it raged for day and night, and the end, it seemed, was not in sight. And they loaded up cannons with nails and chains, a noise that drive a man insane. Rifles sang sharp and loud through that battle in the cloud. Gray coat soldiers have gone, marching in a ragged war. Young wives and babies cried alone, alone. For father, they sung a moan. For father, they sung a
here's a song off Norman Blake's newest album. It's called Old Gray Mare.
Once I had an old gray mare, she couldn't see and she couldn't hear. Well, I took her down in the field to plow, Lord, I took her down in the field to plow. Took her in the field to plow, and the damned old fool, she didn't know how. Jumped right up on my knees to pray. Well, I got right down on my knees to pray. Got right down on my knees to pray. Scared the damned old fool away. Well, I jumped right up and I followed the tracks. Lord, I jumped right up and I followed the tracks. So I jumped right up and I followed the tracks. Found her in a mud hole, flat in the back. Once I had an old gray mare, once I had an old gray mare, once I had an old gray mare, she couldn't see and she couldn't hear.
Well, Rick, here's a song that Phoebe Snow did originally, and I try very hard to do it, but I can't do it quite as good as she is. She does, but Bill and I are we've worked it up, and we're going to do it for you right now.
Comes from down in Southern.
right there. Turn it on.
He's up here. Oh, he got a head up. Rick, I'm just going to do a little bit of picking for you now. Don't start that stuff, Zoe. My God, Zoe. Thank you.
I'm sure this next song needs no introduction. Well, Ricky, I'm sure this next song needs no introduction.
Might as well, we can't shit. No, go ahead and erase it. No, erase it. It's
alright. Here it goes, Rick. We're gonna leave that not.
Really?
It's
none. Thank God.
Thank God.
Need it, need it, need it. Please, Mr. Custard. I don't want to go. Oh, please, Mr. Custard. I don't want to go. Cause there's a man outside with a gun, and he's gonna shoot me down right now. So please, Mr. Custard, don't make me go. Please, Mr. Custard.
Hey, I don't wanna go. Look here, Mr. Custard. No, no, no. I ain't even gonna go. You see, I had this dream last night. And I saw this Indian, and he shot me. So, no, no, no. You ain't even gonna make me go.
Oh, listen, Mr. Custard. Honestly, I just can't go. Oh, what size jockstrap do you wear? Listen, Mr. Custard, if you make me go, I'll get killed. I'll be glad to stay here and help out with all of the nurse work. There's a lot of soldier patients, you know, and they're all males. So, please, Mr. Custard.
Listen, I just can't go. Not tonight, anyhow. Are you off tonight, by the way?
Jive-ass tugging motherfucker, I ain't even gonna go with you. You must be crazy if you think I'm gonna go out there and put my life on the line for some nigga white person. What's wrong with you, honky? You must be. Listen here, I'm gonna tell you something. You can go out there and you can get killed, honey, but I ain't even go out there. You and your mama can go. I don't even want to see your face around here no more, boy. Oh, please, Mr. Custard. Please don't make me go. Please, Mr. Custard. I don't want to go. Because there's a red skin outside my door. He's gonna shoot me 4x4. Oh, please, Mr. Custard, please don't make me go.
Let's keep it rolling. No, not the same song. Let's just keep it rolling. Let's not turn off the tape until it ends, no matter what happens. If we both fall asleep, who cares?
All right. What do we do next? Improvise or what? Improvise. You want music to improvision? How about a blues number, Zoe?
Okay.
Rick, this is going to be a Zoe original at the very moment. Here it comes, Zoe. Think fast.
Thank God. Thank God, dirt up your mind.
Well, you took me out in your fancy car. You bought me fine wine and fine clothes. But I can't stand a man who turns and cheats on me. So, honey, get on out the door. I ain't stand it no more. I can't stand it no more, honey. Hop on out that door. I don't wanna see your face, honey, anymore. Now you're known across town for having a chick on each arm. Oh, yeah. And then you come home to me and you say, hey, let's do it. Do it. Do it. And I said, I can't stand it no more. Get out the door.
How about another beat and another key? Still a blues, but just a different.
Some people say that they can't listen to the blues, but when I'm blue, ain't nothing like the blues. Oh yeah, they make me feel all right. Ain't no strife. You got to be into what you're trying to listen to. So listen to me good and try to learn the blues. get a do bop beach, sing be baku. Say we group, say we group, we do.
That one's hard. We promised we wouldn't take anything off. It's a take. Can't, don't touch that dial.
This is what I get for buying those 90-minute tapes. The last 30 minutes of it ended up like this, but oh well. This is what we sit around and pick whenever we're just hanging out, kind of having a good time. Get me and Zoe together with the guitar and her voice, and we'll come up with something by George.
Ain't done. Bill. Remember, do you think we could do that Bonnie Raitt song? Do you remember it? Remember, love me like a man? Love me like a man? Let's talk about A flat.
A flat.
A flat. Let's talk about E.
The blues?
Yeah, it's kind of bluesy. Let's see.
Kind of, well, give me an idea.
Okay, I'm getting ready to. Let's see. Entertain Rick while I'm thinking of the thought.
Okay, Rick. Well, Phil's thinking of the thought. Here goes a guitar number for you. It's called, I'll do Deputy Dolph. Let me find my tape.
Bye, Rick.
Good night, John Boy.
Good night, Mary Ellen.
Good night, Mama.
Night, Daddy.